Hi, this is Gopal Kamath and welcome to getyourrestaurant.com, where we help you to set up your own restaurants and to create a chain of restaurants. So today I've got a very, very special topic and I'm very excited about this topic. And this is about how to franchise your brand. So how to franchise your brand. So a brand means any kind of a business under a brand. So it doesn't mean only restaurants. It doesn't mean only jewelry shops. It can be anything. It can be electronic shop, it can be a jewelry shop, any kind of business with a name which produces profits is very attractive for other people who don't know how to produce profits. Restaurants is one of them. So the overall franchising is a concept where you give your name and your technique of creating profits by giving products and services to other people, and you get a brand fee out of it as well as royalty monthly basis on when the business starts making profits. So there are a lot of advantages of franchising your brand compared to the disadvantages. There are a few disadvantages also. The first advantage is your liquidity is like it increases like anything. So let's say, for example, I am owning a restaurant and I have a restaurant in one location, but in the other location I want to have a restaurant, but I don't want to put money, I don't want to take a lot of loan or a lot of, you know, capital expenditure. I might use the money somewhere else. So when a person approaches me, or when I approach a person, what I tell him to do is, you put the money, I will give you my name, I will give you the systems, we will run the show, and when the business starts making profit, may it be a restaurant or any other thing, I will share the profits or I will share the revenue, depending on the type of agreement which you do. So this is how a franchising is. The number one advantage is you don't need to put in any capital. They pay you the brand fee, so it's like extra money for you. They pay you every month profit, so it is again extra money for you by the way of royalties. The only thing is, your business should be making profits. If your business is itself not making profits, I suggest this is not the time for you to expand via franchising, via expansion. The number one thing which you should do, if you are into a business, you are owning a restaurant or any other thing, and if you are running the show, make sure that outlet itself is making profits. Only if it is making profits for around 3 or 4 years, then you can approach a investor and convince him to put money in your brand by taking a franchisee. So let's move to the topic of the day. It is how to franchise your brand. So the number one, let me get the marker. So the number one thing is, you have to own the brand. So you have to register your brand. So let's say, for example, your restaurant's name is XYZ restaurant. So you have to own the rights to that brand, and only after you own the rights to that brand, you can give it to somebody else in order to open a restaurant by name. If you are not owning the brand, it is actually stupid to go ahead and give it to somebody else, because what will happen is, the person who is really owning the brand might put a case on you, might put a case on the other person, and it will be a very, very big hassle. So TM stands for trademark. You can register the brand, trademark the brand by spending a little bit of money, hiring agencies who generally help you in trademarking your registered name. The second is systems. So once you have your brand, you have to create systems in your business. So there are systems for purchasing vendors, there are systems for producing the products and services. So let's say, for example, in a restaurant, you have to have systemized your recipes. What kind of recipe requires what? Let's say, for example, there is a medu vada and chutney. So what is the recipe of a medu vada? Which kind of dal you are using? Which salt you are using? Which kind of oil you are using? So you have to first fix these all things, because these all things will make sure that you get the same quality in your other restaurants or in your other outlets. If you have not fixed these systems, everything will go haywire. The franchisee might order something else, you know, then he might order some different ingredient, and your taste of your product itself might differ. So that is one of the reason why, in order to avoid mistakes in quality, you have to first fix up what is the exact quality which you are using, which the guests in the other restaurant might come and eat. So that's one of the reason why if you see in a McDonald's or your Pizza Hut, Domino's, everything is systemized. They have fixed vendors, they have their fixed products, fixed cheese, everything is fixed, including the branding. So make sure you do that. The third thing is legalize. You have to be very, very strict with your legal agreements and compliance of the agreements. As you know, I am the founder of Get Your Restaurant, so I consult a lot of big brands to increase their network by helping them market. So a lot of times the owners of the brands become little lenient, you know, and they let the franchisee take advantage of it. The franchisee starts doing things which are really hurting the brand. So I would strongly suggest you, everything which you want in your restaurant or in your brand should be put on paper and made to be complied by the franchisee. If the franchisee is not signing on the paper, that itself means that your brand is open for a lot of trials and errors. It is going to erode the brand. It is going to create, and please note, if that doesn't mean once you have increased your number of outlets, if an outlet in some other part of the town has a bad review, it will affect the whole brand. So please don't make sure that mine is fine, the other brand is getting. No, it is one and the same brand. The outlet somewhere else, if it gets affected, the whole brand is getting affected, and your marketplace, you are losing a lot of goodwill in the marketplace. So make sure that you bind your franchisee in a legal terms with all the things which you want him to comply with. If not, you better don't take a franchise, because anyways you are going to end up spoiling the whole brand. The fourth thing is the P&L. As I said earlier, you have to make sure that your outlet is in profit, because once your outlet is in profit, only after that you will be able to convince the client, the franchisee, that I am making profits. The same scenario exists in your location, and you are also likely to make profits. So if you are not doing any profit, please don't franchise your brand. The fifth is then promote. Once you get all these four things, then you promote your franchisee. You promote your franchise to other people. I will do a detailed video on promotions, because this is my expertise, how to promote your brand. But before doing that, you need to have these four systems. So if you have not registered a brand, if you don't have any system, if you don't have an agreement ready, and if you are not making profits, anyways I am not going to work with you, because you need to have something in order to grow. I cannot grow zero. Please don't mind me, I am very frank over here. So promotion, there are a lot of things which you can do to promote. I will do a completely different video on promoting your franchise. Sixth is then give them support. The people who are taking your franchise are, they first of all want to make profits, and secondly they have fallen in love with your product. So, but they are not hoteliers or restaurateurs themselves, or for that matter, if you are a jeweler, they are not jewelers themselves. So they don't know anything about this business. They are just putting in the money. So once you give them your brand, once you give them your name, you have to make sure that they don't spoil it, as well as it doesn't get spoiled by leaving it on chance. So you have to create a small team which will handle their operations, which will handle their complete flow of customers, in order to make sure that the same experience is given to them, the experience which is happening at your own outlet. And the seventh is then manage. You have to manage the whole show for them by keeping in a little bit of more staffing. Cost of that staffing will again come from the royalties which you are getting, as well as the brand fee which you are getting. So you make sure that you give them good support. The number one reason why people don't go for franchising is that fear that they will not have the support. So if you are really serious about it, don't expand your brand as if, you know, people, it's like just by sporadically expanding your brand, you open just one outlet in 6 months or a year, but make sure that that outlet is successful. If that outlet is successful, automatically a lot of people will come and ask for you, and it will be easy for you to scale also. Very sporadic growth is highly unsustainable, and you will not be able to, hold on to that growth. The faster you grow, the faster you might come down. The eighth is then expand. Only expand once you have all these seven things ready, everything is working smoothly, you have your systems in place, you have your profits in place, each and every outlet which you're opening is doing profit. Don't grow very sporadically, because it will really create a mess in the long run. So these are the eight things which will help you to franchise your brand. I hope you have loved it. Do comment on this video, and I would love to have your thoughts on it. Make sure that you subscribe to this channel. This is the Get Your Restaurant channel. Everything about restaurants, how to open a restaurant and create a chain of restaurants. And do go to my website www.getyourrestaurant.com/shop. Check out the books. There is the online training program on how to set up your restaurant. If you like it, get it. If you don't like it, it's cool. So I'm so happy that you went through this video. You stayed till then. Thank you so much, and see you on the next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.